Brandon, does your daughter know how to box yet?
She's starting to throw punches, yes.
She gonna be a killer? Is she gonna turn a pro, be a champion?
Her
she's watching YouTube? Watching her dad?
Her cognitive ability to understand that it's not acceptable to throw punches all the time is not catching up with her ability to throw the punches.
So she's hitting people?
She's hitting people, yes. Bowen. Yeah, you're not gonna do it right now.
She's starting to look like you. She didn't look like you before.
She's pretty like mommy.
She's starting to look like you, Brandon.
She's tough like daddy.
Throw some punches. Show daddy your muscles.
She's watching SpongeBob or something.
She's watching something, exactly.
She loves Elmo.
Elmo. Tickle me, Elmo.
Elmo.
Did you go trick-or-treating?
She experienced her second Halloween, and yeah, she did some trick-or-treating. It was great. She was a devil.
Devil?
She was a little baby devil. Here, boy, come and daddy. Look at this big girl. Can I get a kiss?
Brad, would you want your daughter to be a boxer? Like compete?
I'm not gonna push it on her, but yeah, absolutely. I think boxing is the true sport that teaches all the things that sports are supposed to teach you.
But
grit, determination, stick-to-itiveness, dealing with adversity, the thrill of victory, and also the agony of defeat.
A lot of people in boxing don't want their kids to be in boxing. A lot of fighters tell me that. Any other sport, not boxing, because they're fighters and they know what they go through. And it's not like what you think is on the outside.
How about this? I don't want her to approach it necessarily
as a career.
A life or death career. I definitely want her to experience the beauty of boxing.
You trained me at St. John. You won a world title with her. But you wouldn't want your own daughter to be a pro fighter, necessarily.
I wouldn't want her to be a pro fighter in the sake that it's her only option.
What would you want her to be if you had a choice?
I want her to be creative and smart, and I want her to pick her own path.
So do what she wants. But she likes boxing so far.
She's coming to the gym.
She's 2.5.
Yes.
That's too young for anybody, obviously. What's the youngest age for someone to come here and say, I want to train?
We, occasionally we'll get people like 7, 5. 8. Nah, 5. Like, you gotta
5 is
have,
too young?
Cognitively, you gotta have some. I gotta be able to explain some things, you know what I mean?
Okay, what I noticed, especially with Latinos, the kids at home start boxing at her age. Hello. By the time they come to your gym at 7, they're already sharp. They already have some. They already know to throw the 1-2. They already.
Well, absolutely. You know, somebody like Floyd Mayweather is probably a similar situation, or an Eric Morales, growing up in a boxing gym.
Robert at 5 was boxing. Robert Garcia.
You know what I mean? So give her another 2.5 years, and we'll see what's happening.
All right, there you have it.
But then, she's like indoctrinated in that world. I think it would be a lot different if a parent dropped a 5-year-old off to me and was like, okay, do your magic. No. Her growing up in this world, like, if at 5 the girl could throw punches, it wouldn't be surprising at all. But if a parent comes to me and says, start training my 5-year-old, I'm going to be like, it's too young.
You're 1, 7, 8, 9.
Yeah.
You had a kid that was really young. He came with his dad. His dad was on a motorcycle.
I get a lot of young kids.
And you give him a chance? As
we even have a kid's class. Matias, one of my top fighters, teaches it. Monday through Thursday, 5:30, 6:30. It's 12 and under. And it's kids beget kids also. Because so one little kid comes in and sees a kid training, he'll be more inclined to stay. Then they can drill with each other and get better together and things like that.
All right, there you have it. Brandon Krause right here. Stay tuned. Please report.com. Elie Seckbach reporting. They open up a new...